heart attack can change your life in an instant. It can be scary and overwhelming. This happens to 70,000 Canadians each year. And on top of this, 12% are readmitted within the first 30 days. This can be both costly as well as detrimental to one's quality of life. While reducing readmissions is a complex issue, one potential solution is to try and improve patients' self-management skills, as well as to provide more support once they've gone home. In Canada, we have great care if you're hospitalized for an urgent issue, but we don't always provide quite as much support as we could when you're discharged. And this is a problem because someone might encounter numerous challenges, such as managing new medications, feeling overwhelmed and not knowing what to ask, feeling alone with setbacks, or trying to make changes to long-standing behaviors to your diet and physical activity. All of these are important, though, because they help promote recovery as well as prevent future events. So we want to learn if using text messages can help patients during this transition period. Why text messages? Well, first of all, they're a very common technology. Our past work showed that about 70% of heart patients currently text. Additionally, it's very cheap, costing less than 1 cent per message to send. You can also send out information in small, bite-sized pieces, and it can be accessed when convenient to the user. So what we did is we designed a series of text messages to send out over the first 60 days after someone's been discharged. We created these messages with the input of health professionals such as doctors, nurses, pharmacists, and I'm getting some feedback, as well as several patients and researchers. These topics, or these messages, cover a range of topics, such as recommended medical appointments, as well as, I'm not sure what to do about that, as well as social support, community resources that someone can access, like telephone hotlines, and information about smoking cessation, diet, and physical activity. We're in the process of testing these text messages in 76 heart attack patients. One half is receiving the messages, while the other half is not, and then we'll compare the two groups for things like their self-management skills, their medication adherence, as well as the number of times they went to go see their doctor or went to the hospital. I'm still in the process of finalizing my data, so unfortunately I don't have any results to share at this point, but stay tuned and perhaps I'll be back next year. So in conclusion, recovering from a heart attack is not always an easy process, but we want to learn whether using a common technology in a new way can help patients feel more confident to manage and take control of their health. Thank you.